Wedding bells are ringing. It's the wedding of Paul Vachon. Thanks for tuning in to another special episode of Tyler Vance Rants. I am your host, Tyler Vance himself, and you're not. It is December 18th, 1984, and 2 weeks ago on Tuesday Night Titans, we went through the preparations of the wedding that we're about to attend tonight. Now that it's time, we join both Vince McMahon and Lord Awful Alfred Hayes in the wedding chapel, which is designed to look like a wrestling ring. I'm loving this! Howard Finkel goes over the rules of the wedding, as if the participants were going to compete in a match.
Before we begin the festivities, there are a few announcements that I must make.
No throwing objects, no blocking the aisle, or else the guilty parties will be subject to prosecution. Hear, hear! Each member of the wedding party is then introduced as if they are competing in actual matches, as Howard Finkel goes through the entire wedding party.
The Reverend Meyer Lipschitz, the best man, Mad Dog Vachon, the groom of this evening's wedding, Paul the Butcher Vachon, the maid of honor, the fabulous Moolah, and now flower girl, Diamond Lil.
Wait a minute. Wait. Hey, wait a minute.
The ring bearer, Sky. Low. Low.
Oh, all right. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, no. Are you kidding me? The ring went flying.
The bride, Ophelia. And giving the bride away, George, the animal, Steel.
There's some people here in this place that came here uninvited.
You sold me a ticket for $10.
The Reverend takes both Paul and Ophelia through the entire ceremony. And near the end, it's revealed that Ophelia has the same color tongue as George the Animal Steel does. There might be a relation there that we just don't know about.
Wait a minute, I got a reason. Wait a minute, Rev. You shut
Alpano
up.
Is objecting.
You're my friend. What are you doing this
because
for?
Because she's a virgin. Lily White virgin. No.
Don't worry about it. No, she's not a virgin. Don't worry about it.
What'd you say, Paul?
With Captain Albano's concerns addressed, it's now time for Paul and Ophelia to be pronounced husband and wife. You may kiss the bride. But wait, Dr. D. David Schultz now has an objection. He absolutely body slams Paul Vachon. What a joker the doctor is. Chaos breaks out. People start sprinting out of the chapel as if their lives are literally on the line after the good doctor's actions. But they fail to realize it's just a prank, bro. After everyone's cleared the area, both Vince McMahon and Lord Awful Alfred Hayes take the opportunity to talk to some of the wedding guests one-on-one. And the first guest that they speak to is someone that we have not seen in some time due to injury, Jesse the Body Ventura. The Body himself states that he's been working hard for his planned return to in-ring action soon. But this isn't what Vince McMahon chooses to focus on. Rather, McMahon points a finger at Jesse Ventura, blaming him for some of the actions which led to the breakdown of the wedding ceremony.
Jesse the Body Ventura, you certainly did not help matters any at all.
Oh boy, here we go.
Well, that's just too bad. You know, I look at it this way. There should always be a little violence and love.
Oh, and in case you were wondering who does Jesse the Body Ventura's hair?
The person who designed my hair, you know very well, Cyndi Lauper.
Since McMahon is about to make me very angry with his insinuations about Jesse Ventura, perhaps it's best that we move on to footage of a match between the Body and the Polish Power, Ivan Putski, one-on-one. This is the culmination of a feud that started earlier this year of 1984. July 28th, to be precise, when the Polish Power was absolutely bodied by the Body. If you haven't seen that episode, I'll link it down in the description for your viewing pleasure. Before Putski can even get in the ring, Ventura is all over him, which results in a brawl breaking out between the two, which goes all throughout the ring and ringside area. We unfortunately don't get to see much more of that match, as Vince McMahon brings us back to the wedding chapel, where we move on to our next guest. One thing I do want to address really quickly before we move on to that next interview is that in the recent match, Jesse the Body Ventura outlined some of his injury details to us on guest commentary.
Your taxes are going up, McMahon, because you pay taxes, I presume, right?
Of course.
What happened to the body? I had blood clots in my lungs. Agent Orange. For when I was in Vietnam. So I'm suing the U.S. government.
Vince McMahon and Lord Awful Alfred Hayes' next guests are the Wild Samoans, Afa and Sika.
Things are going quite well over at the reception.
Yes, yes, it was good. We have good time.
The Samoans aren't much for conversation, as English is a second language to them. So instead, we're shown footage of the Wild Samoans taking on former teammates in Mr. Fuji and Tiger Chung Lee, who are immediately brawled to the outside of the ring as soon as the bell rings. Captain Lou Albano then makes his way down to the ringside area, causing confusion between both the Wild Samoans and their opponents. Tiger Chung Lee tries to take advantage of the confusion, headbutting Afa in the ring. However, this proves to be a devastating mistake, as there is nothing harder in this world, reportedly, than the skull of a Samoan. Lee staggers himself and stumbles around the ring before he's put down properly with an actual headbutt from Afa. Despite this, Tiger Chung Lee still manages to get a tag to Mr. Fuji, who drops a headbutt of his own down on the Samoan's midsection. Afa goes on to be double-teamed by Mr. Fuji and Tiger Chung Lee before Chung Lee accidentally collides with Mr. Fuji, which allows Sika to get that desperate tag. Immediately, Sika puts that skull to good use and headbutts his opponent to secure the win for the Wild Samoans. Back to the wedding chapel, Afa does manage to speak that we as the viewers should not be afraid of him and Sika. They're just like everyone else. They love getting paid, and they just want to wrestle. I can relate. Immediately following the departure of the Wild Samoans, Captain Lou Albano is the next guest of Vince McMahon and Lord Awful Alfred Hayes. And McMahon states that some of the captain's behaviors during the wedding ceremony could be considered...
Some of your comments were most embarrassing.
You want to talk embarrassing, McMahon? Take a look in the mirror.
I am ugly personified.
There's actually a very special and important announcement that the captain makes, all jokes about his appearance aside. He has joined the fight against MS, multiple sclerosis, and what a cause to get behind. We can all do our part to force MS to submit and also make Captain Lou Albano proud in the process. I've linked some helpful websites down below for you to check out. Now that the ceremony is over, it's time for the fun part of weddings, the reception. Mr. and Mrs. Paul Vachon attempt to open their very thoughtful gifts, which include rubber bands from Captain Lou Albano, hair dye from Jesse the Body Ventura, eyeglasses from Classy Freddie Blassie, a fish from the Wild Samoans, a plethora of beauty products from the Fabulous Moolah, and a final gift that, frankly, couldn't be shown on TV. Once the gifts are set aside, we're then treated to a match of the groom taking on the Junkyard Dog in singles action. A punch to JYD's gut seems to do some damage. However, a single punch from the dog seconds later on Vachon forces him outside of the ring. Once back inside the squared circle, the Junkyard Dog is forced into a corner and Paul Vachon proceeds to strangle him with the ring rope. JYD immediately responds to this with violence, biting the ear of Paul Vachon, which forces the French Canadian to retreat outside of the ring yet again. It's not long after that that the Junkyard Dog comes away with a win following a thump. Oh sure, let's remind the groom of one of his defeats on the best day of his life. You're something else, McMahon, and it ain't good. Back at the wedding reception, George the Animal Steel eats a part of his glass as he's approached by Vince McMahon to toast the bride and groom. It takes some encouragement from the other guests in attendance, but eventually the animal is able to belt out a beautiful tribute to both Mr. and Mrs. Paul Vachon.
Pumpernickel!
Afa and Sika give a toast. Captain Lou Albano, as well as several other guests of the wedding party, give their toast to the newlywed couple.
Open your teeth! Open your gums! Look out, stomach! Here it comes!
Except for Dr. D, David Schultz, who's understandably very upset about being asked last.
No, I don't want to toast nobody, man. You've been running around here talking to all the...
Mr. and Mrs. Vachon then share their first dance as husband and wife. and we wouldn't want to interrupt that. So let's go to tonight's main event. Wyndham is able to gain early control of the match following a dropkick on his opponent. As Rex then comes off the ropes, Barry is able to lift the Moondog up for a body slam. Moondog Rex then goes to the ropes to break a headlock that Barry Wyndham locked on, causing him to unceremoniously be dumped on his head. Despite this, the Moondog is able to fight back with some surgically placed punches before he himself is punched outside of the ring by Wyndham. But never count a Moondog out, as Barry Wyndham finds his legs pulled out from underneath him, and then Moondog Rex gets into the ring again, only to bite his opponent in the face. That'll teach you! A nasty elbow from Moondog Rex follows, which sends Wyndham crashing over the ropes and down onto the floor, burning into the guardrail. To his credit, Barry Wyndham does manage to crawl back into the ring for more punishment, being tossed over the ropes neck first before suffering Rex's backbreaker, which results in a near fall. Despite all of the damage suffered at the hands of Moondog Rex, Barry Wyndham is able to come back swinging, reversing a reverse backbreaker into a backdrop of his own, but subsequently misses a dropkick as Moondog Rex comes off the ropes, which results in another near fall for Rex following an elbow drop. Moondog Rex then tries to splash Barry Wyndham in the corner, but misses, which opens the way for Barry Wyndham to employ his bulldog and walk away with the win. Weddings are magical. Not only is it the day of days for the bride and groom, but it can be special for everyone as emotions run high and make good men do questionable things, such as when Captain Lou Albano seemingly makes peace with the Wild Samoans and even the Tonga Kid, singing a Samoan song together. Sky Lolo even joins the troupe in singing, however Captain Lou Albano seems to come to his senses as he subsequently makes a fool of Lolo. Paul and Ophelia Vachon attempt to then cut their wedding cake, however Dr. D. David Schultz still has a question that needs to be asked.
Woman, do you know how to take care of a man?
Mad Dog Vachon takes exception with the way that the good doctor is speaking to his sister-in-law. So, Dr. D. David Schultz does what any gentleman would do in this situation. Peacefully walk back to his seat. What? Did you expect the doctor to fight the Mad Dog on TV during a wedding? What kind of trash TV do you think this is? The cake is cut. But Mrs. Ophelia Vachon states that she doesn't want a piece because she doesn't like cake.
Oh, but I don't eat cake, dear.
Well, no offense, lady, but why'd you order a cake then?
I don't like
Well, I like cake, see? I like cake. Won't you take
No!
All chaos breaks loose as the wedding reception turns into a massive food fight. With that, Tuesday Night Titans comes to an end. And thank goodness, I didn't want to ruin my jacket. Thanks for tuning in to another special episode of Tyler Vance Rants. Don't forget that you can like the video, hit the bell, and subscribe so you never miss when a new episode is released. You can also follow me on social media where I share wrestling-related material on a daily basis. That's all for now. So long. When the Ivan Putski power. No. If you haven't seen that episode, I'll link it in this. What's this that I keep doing today? Why do I keep doing this?